Only about 15% of GRE test takers got this question right. That's less than a random guess. I think it's mostly because of one word in the question, which shows us one of the simplest, yet powerful, techniques for calculating probabilities. I've changed this question a bit, but the mathematical ideas are the same. Here's the question. There are 12 cell phones in a box. Two of the phones are defective. You select two phones at random from the box simultaneously. What's the probability that neither of the two phones you select are defective? As written, this problem is solved with a counting technique called combinations, which many people taking the GRE may not know or remember. There are 10 working phones. Out of these, we choose two. That's 10 choose two. Then we divide this by the total number of ways to pick two phones, which is 12 choose two. This gives the answer. But can we solve this problem without needing combinations? I think the reason a lot of test takers miss this one is the word simultaneously. I think this word discourages people from finding the solution that doesn't require knowing combinations. The probability of drawing two working phones simultaneously is the same as the probability of picking two working phones one by one. We call this sampling without replacement. We pick one phone, and then we pick another phone from the remaining ones in the box. So now let's answer this question thinking of the phones one at a time, sampling without replacement. For the first phone, there are 10 working ones out of 12 total, so that's a probability of 10 out of 12 for that event. Then for the second phone, there are only 9 remaining working ones since we just picked one of them out of 11 remaining phones. So the probability is 9 out of 11. Since we want the probability of the first event and then the second, we multiply these fractions together to get 90 out of 132, which simplifies to 15 out of 22. I have to imagine that that word simultaneously threw many test takers off of this solution. It would still be a pretty challenging question for the general GRE, but I have to imagine the scores wouldn't have been quite so low. Has the wording of an exam question ever led you astray? Let us know what happened in the comments. Please consider liking and subscribing to support the channel. It really helps a lot. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.